my friends, I'm back with another spreadsheet tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how I keep track of all my submissions. Whether it's submissions to magazines, contests, or grant applications, or applications to residencies, really anything you might want to track. And I'll be using the word unfortunately in place of rejected or declined,
as we're all too used to seeing on submittable.
In homage to Adrienne Dawes, a playwright I met through Artist 360 and who I admire deeply. Adrienne hosts the Unfortunately Challenge, where she challenges people to reach 100 unfortunately's in a year. I'll leave a link to her site below, and she has a much more complicated version of this that you can download for free on there. It's really, really cool, but I had a lot of issues navigating it, maybe because it was made with playwrights in mind, more than the types of things I want to track, but also just because it was a little too complicated for me. So here's my much more simplified version, and you should be able to customize this to fit whatever your needs are. So you're gonna start by typing in your header row. These are the things that I like to track, but obviously your mileage may vary. And then I like to clean up the columns, just make sure everything looks okay. Center everything, make it a bit bigger. Now we're gonna change the formatting. I don't like any of these colors, so I'm gonna change the theme. Mark that your table has headers. Okay, I like this one more. And then I also like it when the first and last column are filled in. Clean it up a bit. Make this bigger. So now I'm making a box here so that we can keep track of total payment over time. Making sure it's formatted correctly so that it shows up as currency. And now I'm going to show you how to make drop-down options for the genre and status columns. Again, these are just the options I pick, but feel free to do whatever you want. Instead of having a rejected option, I'm having an unfortunately option. And it's carrying over the coloring that I used when I first built this. I just copied the document so it still has some of the old stuff, but I'll show you how to color it yourself. So this is how you color in specific colors for the various options. You have to make sure it says custom, and then select your fill. Let's pick this for poetry. Go into font to make it bold and change the color of the text to white. Click OK. Make sure you select specific text and then containing. And then write in whatever the title is and click OK. go to data and then validation and click list under the options. Make sure you source the correct row for your options, and they should show up now. And it's still giving you the old colors I had, but I'll just put them in so you can see. And do the same to the status row. Select your options. Planned is a new addition. I didn't have this in my original spreadsheet because it didn't occur to me until now, but I think it's a good thing to have so that you can plan things ahead of time. You know, like when you find out that there's a journal that you want to submit to, but maybe they're not currently open for submission, so you can just plan it. And I like to hide these, so just right click and press hide. I'm sure there's a better way to do it, but I haven't found one. Let me know if you find one. And there you have it. That's how I track my submissions. I hope this is useful. Let me know if you have any questions, and thank you so much for joining me today. Be sure to like and subscribe, and let me know what tutorials you want to see in the future. I think we might be doing Scrivener next month, so let me know what questions you have about that, and I'll try to cover them. And I'll see you next week.